Hello everybody, welcome back to The Cutting Edge. So today I'm going to take the beard off. I'm also going to do a head shave. As you have seen at the beginning of this video, the shave gear I'm going to use today, I'm going to start off with introducing the shaving cream. This one is a Taylor Revol Bond Street. It's the coconut scent. Very great scent. It's a very good cream, a very good post-shave feeling. So if you don't have it and you want to try out a coconut scent, I really advise it to check it out. For the razors, because for the head shave I will be using my Mercure 34C. For the beard shave I will be using the Yaki Beast head along with the handle that I bought off AliExpress. This one is the Yaki Beast head. It's a very nice handle, also from AliExpress. It's a very heavy handle. And for the head shave, I will be using the Mercure 34C. The blade that I have loaded in there are the Treat blades. So for the two razors, I have the same blade. It's the Treat blade. I like the Treat blades very well. For the brush, I will be using the Yaki brush. This one, it's the 24. Yes, you can see it here. It's the 24. So beautiful handle, very nice knot on it. I already soaked it a little. You can see it at the tips. So I will be using this for the shave today. Hope you stick with me, and I'm going to begin making a ladder, and then I will come back to you for the shave. So stay tuned. So today I will be making a bowl ladder. So here I got some of the cream loaded up into my bowl. This is not a shaving bowl, it's just something I picked up in a thrift shop, but it does the job, so why not? So I'm going to load up my brush, make some ladder. And the scent you get, it's like opening up a coconut. It's really a nice scent, it's really subtle. And I know from experience that this ladder can also take a lot of water. So I'm just going to try to create a nice ladder so I can have a great shave, a great pose feeling. And as you can see, it started to build a beautiful ladder. Also in the bowl. So, like you can see, I have a great ladder on there. You can see those little peaks. The scent on this, I would give it 8 out of 10. For the scent strength, maybe it's about a 6. But for the quality of the scent, it's like eating a coconut or just opening up a coconut. Very beautiful ladder. Here you can see it. This is about, I think, a week's growth. And I have a relatively tough beard, so I'll hope that Beast Head will just cut through everything. I don't know if you can pick this up on camera, but it's gonna be a very thick ladder. I got plenty of ladder in the bowl. I do have to give a little warning. If you use this kind of head and you order the Yaki Beast, be very careful with it, because when you have a new blade in it and the slant head is very aggressive, you feel the metal on your skin, so be very gentle with the touch if you shave. It's not a beginner head, that I can tell you for sure. I've been shaving about 4 years. This is the first time I used it after 4 years. I could have used it earlier on because my technique is getting there. But I just wanted to mention that if you're a beginner and you wanted to try this razor, give other razors a try before you try this one, and I will go ahead, do the shave, and I will come back to you after the first pass. So normally I don't go against with the grain or across the grain. I normally shave a little bit different, so don't mind my technique. If you have a technique that works for you, awesome. I just have my technique, so don't pay any attention to the technique. There are a lot of videos out there on technique with the grain, against the grain, etc. Check those videos out if you're new to wet shaving or new to the traditional way of shaving. I just wanted to mention that. So I will do my first pass, but if you have comment on the technique, it's just the thing I use, what works for me. Like Chris always says, do what works for you, also with the ladder. So for me, it's the same against the grain, with the grain, or cross the grain. I know if you can see it or not, but about a week's worth of growth, and it just cuts through it like a lawnmower. I don't know if you can pick up the audio feedback, but this razor is really amazing, or this head. You should be very gentle on the touch if you use this razor, because it's an aggressive razor, so if you put too much pressure, you will nick yourself or you will get some cuts. So to prevent that, a very light touch. And also, the creamer I'm using, it's a very slick cream, it gives you very good protection. That's it for the first pass. I'm going to rinse, I'm going to re-lather, and then I'm going to do a second pass. So stay tuned. Wow, that yucky beast head is amazing. He took off almost everything after one pass. I still got a little bit of hair left here on the neck. But I have to say, strength-wise, the cream is awesome. It's been a long time since I've used this cream. Just a little disclaimer, maybe you see some redness up here. Just because I have really sensitive skin, it doesn't mean that it's awful because of the head, the razor blade, or the cream. It just I have real sensitive skin. Maybe you can see it here. I also have some red spots or here on above. So it's nothing to do with the cream or the head or the razor itself, just my skin. Just wanted to point that out for anybody that maybe thinks it's the razor. Still got plenty of cream left in the brush. So, second pass. I did get a little cut right up here. So it's like I told you, I already have been shaving for 4 years. My technique is good, and you see I still get a cut from time to time because it's a very aggressive head. You have to pay very close attention. So for the second pass, I'm going to rinse off. And I have to say, that felt amazing. plenty of slickness that remains on the face. Maybe I will do a little touch up just on my neck. And sorry guys if I don't talk too much during the shave. I'm just getting into these videos and making them, so I'm not as comfortable in front of the camera as I should be. Maybe you noticed it in the previous videos, but I will do my best. If you have any questions, leave them down below. So I'm very happy with that. Feels very smooth. There's plenty of slickness left on the face from the cream. So I'm gonna leave it with that. I'm just going to rinse off. And then I'm gonna do the post shave. So I'm just gonna use my little Allen block. For the post shave, after rinsing off, I use this product. I don't know if it's available in the US or in Australia. And after that dried up, I'm going to use Nivea, the Nivea balm. I have plenty of that in stock. So for my sensitive skin, if it's one of those days or like this that I had a week's growth, that I knew that the razor is gonna feel a little bit that my skin is left irritated, I always use the balm. It gives a very soothing, comfortable post-shave feeling. That's it for the beard shave. Now I'm going to prepare to do the head shave. The head shave will be with the Mercure 34C. So we're back for the head shave. Still got plenty of leather left. I'm just going to add a few drops of water to the brush. And you can see that beautiful leather just building up. You don't have to put much effort onto it. Just a lot of water and plenty of love. I'm very happy with that leather. Just going to paint it on. So, Mercure 34C for the head shave. So for me, for the dome shave, I think my Mercure 34C is my go-to razor because it just worked for my head. Now, I recently saw a video at IMCBD. He did a head shave with the Rockwell 6S, or was it the Model T? I think it was the Model T, and he didn't like the head shave at all. Now, I have tried the Model T also, and I must say the Mercure 34C in that regard is 10 times much better. I don't know if it's the design of the head, but it just works, and it just works flawlessly. So I'm going to leave it at that for the first pass. plenty of slickness left. Quick rinse. I'm very happy with that shave. It's very close. I just need to do a little touch up on the back. And like I mentioned before, I do use cartridges just to do a little touch up. So this is, I think it's a Gillette. Add a little water. Now you see I didn't add any cream because the slickness is still there from the soap, so I don't need to lather again. I'm very happy and I will leave it at that. So I will do the same, I will rinse off, put the alum block on, then I will have the tonic on, and after that I will put the Nivea on, so stay tuned. So that was it for the video today. I know it was a long video, so thank you for bearing with me. I hope to see you in the next videos. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe, it will really start my channel. And I will hope to see you in the next videos. Leave a comment down below. And as always, spread the shaving love. Thank you again for watching. Bye.